Did you know that women have more sensitive noses, Larry?
What?
And we can hear things at higher frequencies.
Oh, well, yeah.
We, of course, have the longer life expectancy than men by about 5 years. In her new New York Times bestseller, Cat Bohannon set out to find a sort of user manual for the female with the idea that it will tell us so much about 200 million years of evolution.
Her book is Eve, How the Female Body Drove 200 Million Years of Human Evolution. Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
Doing
good.
Well.
Good to have you with us. Why has all this been so mysterious for centuries, apparently?
Turns out not just sexism, but also that. Yeah, so it turns out that in most biological science, including biomedical science, we are only studying male bodies, from mouse all the way up to human, and that's only recently starting to change. And you would think it was sexism, but it was actually trying to control for the scientific messiness of what happens in a body when it has a menstrual cycle. But that meant effectively from mouse all the way up through primate, through all the way up to human clinical trials, we were only studying males, which of course then naturally affects the drugs that go onto the market, which were understudied in female bodies.
Mm-hmm. It is interesting that you say you believe the most important human evolution is the science of gynecology. And is that just because women lived longer after dying for so many years in childbirth?
It is absolutely the case that even today, far too many women and girls suffer through reproductive problems and horrible outcomes.
Yeah.
Particularly people of color in the United States. So that's a major problem. But in our deep past, millions and millions of years ago, if we were bad at making babies, which ancient hominins were, then the most important thing for continuing species forward would be helping them survive it. We're the only species that regularly helps one another get birth. Hmm. And that started 3 million years ago.
Oh.
You say girls score better until puberty. Why? What happens?
Sexism catches up. I think that's largely the story. I spent about 10 years digging into the scientific research on sex differences in the brain, and the vast majority of them are shockingly small, actually, that in many cases, girls test better in nearly every subject until about puberty, which may well be when girls finally internalize that we're apparently supposed to be bad at math, but actually, no, it turns out we're not.
Really? So it seems odd. I mean, I'm thinking of my girls, and neither of them really just liked math. I mean, there's nothing in the brain. I'm curious. It's so odd. I was always boys math, girls verbal.
Well, I was a mathlete. I mean, mostly because they fed us donuts, but I did that.
So there's no science to it. There's no science to it.
The science exists, but it's very thin.
Ah.
The statistical signal is very weak, actually. We make more of that signal culturally than actually exists in the data. The one thing that male students are better at is picturing a box in their mind and then rotating it and answering questions based on that new position of a box. That's called spatial logic. So they're slightly faster at that. Not more accurate if you give the female test taker enough time, but slightly faster. That's the only signal I was able to reliably find.
All right, this sounds like something you made up or I found on the internet. Only humans and killer whales experience menopause.
I know, and we only found out about the toothed whales because it's hard to study stuff in water. So yeah, we finally did find out things about menopause in orca, in certain kinds of killer whales. And what's amazing about them is we tell this story about grandmothers that they're good for helping out with the childcare. As a parent of two young children, I appreciate help with childcare. It's not that I discount that. However, the other species that has menopause the way we do, they're not helping out with the childcare. What they're good at is when the food runs out, they know where to lead the pod to better food sources. They know they're better at teaching younger orca special ways of getting food, which is to say the value of grandmothers is what they know.
Mm.
Yeah? The value of the elderly in general in social species is wisdom.
Huh, look at that. All right, real quickly, so we smell better and we hear better?
We do. We do.
And that's just science. It's just science.
Is there anything men do better?
It's just science, baby. It's just science.
No, you're in big trouble, Larry. It's just science. Finally, thank you. We appreciate it, Kat. The book is called Eve, and you can find Kat on X. And thanks for being with us.
Thanks. Have a great day.
Thank you. We'll be right back.